ready to match the star. Jack Albertson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Redgrave, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, General. Thank you, dear friends. Yes. Everybody all sat here.
Yes. Very natty dresser, aren't you?
I am a natty and a peachy kid and a neat dancer.
I didn't say that. I said a natty dresser.
He's a wonderful kisser, Lynn, once you get him to the dreaded valley.
What does that mean? These are esoteric people. We have.
Esoteric.
Thank you, Jack.
Isometrics and esoteric.
Yes.
You make a personal comment, and I just go to pieces, my dear.
Do you, darling?
It's the accent.
Get your hands off my body.
Oh, all right. Now let's say hello to Vicki Adler-Bloom and Jean McLaurin. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Vicki's a current champ with $6,400. And she's going to be challenged by Jean McLaurin. Would you please repeat a few things you said about yourself when you were with
us
last time? We really didn't get a good idea of who you are and where you're from and all that.
I'm from Los Angeles, and I'm a county employee for the DPSS, Department of Public Social Service.
Oh.
And I'm from a family of 10. I'm the oldest child of a family of 10. And I have
10 kids in your family?
Yeah, and I'm the oldest.
I see. Well, you don't look so old to me. She doesn't look so old, does she?
No. The others are 9, 8, 7, 6.
Yes. Okay, good luck to you, Gene. Good luck to Vicki, and we'll start this game in 1 minute. Come back. Are you ready?
No.
Yes, we are ready. Here, I push this button and ask Gene to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. New game. Jack said. Any old Jack, just this fellow Jack said, I'm taking a correspondence course in lion taming.
Ooh.
And right now I'm learning how to put my head in the lion's mouth. Now, ooh, since I don't have a lion at home, I practice by sticking my head in the blank. Isn't that the longest question we've ever had?
And the dullest, possibly.
Guy says, take your course in lion taming.
Yeah.
Don't have a lion at home to practice, so I practice by sticking my head in the blank.
Ta-da!
How do you spell Taylor?
You didn't hear anything, did you, now? Did you hear anybody say anything over here that would suggest an answer to you? All right, just want to make sure. What's that? Throw it out. Yeah, I guess maybe someone might have heard it, and that may lead someone to an answer. So, all right, Jack, you're fired. Yes. Then we'll just throw that one out, and we'll do another one. Just throw that away.
I like your
answer. Okay.
I did too.
Now,
I like that.
Why not just change the name and say Fred is
No, that's not a bad suggestion, old bean. So what we'll do is we'll do this one, and then in the meantime, while we're doing this one, why, we'll get another one in there. So a little gnome will sneak in here and put a thing in the slot there while we're doing this one. Now, this is yours, Gene. George said...
I'm taking a correspondence call.
George said...
Tiger tail.
He says, I was just in New York, and I saw this fellow sticking his head... No. He said, I was just in New York, and I saw the strangest thing in Central Park.
How strange was it?
A mugger was mugging a blank.
I got it.
George said, I was just in New York, saw the strangest thing in Central Park. A mugger was mugging a blank.
It's a terrific answer. It's absolutely correct. But haven't you finished yet, little
mugger? No, I haven't even finished.
Have you ever been in New York, Gene?
No.
Well, you know what they make jokes about people being mugged in Central Park all the time. So you just think about that now. All right, she's finished. Everybody finished up there. And we'll be ready to go in a moment or so. Okay. Now, Gene, George said I was just in New York, and I saw the strangest thing in Central Park. A mugger was mugging a blank.
A gorilla.
You've never been to New York?
No.
You've never heard those jokes about how they...
No, how does it go?
Well...
Do you
You'll find out in a moment when we start revealing our answers here. Jack, show her your answer.
Well, I said a mugger was mugging a cop.
Mugger was mugging a cop. You see, that's one possibility, Brett.
Well, I think a mugger was mugging a mugger.
There's the answer. See? Charles?
Another mugger.
Mugger was mugging another mugger. Who, what, hey, who, he, who, she?
Another mugger.
Another mugger. Yes. And Richard.
One mugger to go.
One mugger to go. Oh, so the strangest thing in Central Park, a mugger was mugging a...
Another mugger.
Another mugger. You could have done very well with that, mugger. But that's the idea. Mother. All right, Gene, you didn't do well with yours. Your first round question will be along in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for you, so you watch and listen if you please. Here we are. Now, since we had to throw out one question, we're going to give you your choice of A or B here. What would you like?
A.
You want A. All right. This is your first round question. Everybody plays. In the Garden of Eden, Eve said to the snake, Eve is speaking to the snake, you know, Adam isn't very smart. When I gave him his fig leaf, he put it on his blank. Eve said. She and the snake were sitting around talking. She said, Adam isn't very smart. When I gave him the fig leaf, he put it on his blank. Did you hear all of that? All right, you think about that? Moment or so? Okay, everybody ready? Now we call on Vicky. In the Garden of Eden, Eve said to the snake, you know, Adam isn't very smart. When I gave him his fig leaf, he put it on his blank.
On his head.
On his head. Okay. She said he put the fig leaf on his head. What do you say to that?
I finally made it.
Oh!
Yay! Yay! No timer.
Attaboy, Jack. Okay.
I'll tell him when it comes in.
That's one for you, Vicky. Now, what do you say?
Eve was so mad she snatched it off his head.
Head.
And said, you dummy.
All right, Charles.
I said what the others say.
Head. So that's three heads. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Oh, there it is. I'm four. Terrific. Richard.
Wish I'd written shoulders here.
Head and
get
shoulders.
A shampoo joke going. Al Hedo.
Yes. A lot of head here. That's four, five. One more.
Hello.
Hello there. You're going to break the spell. You didn't say.
No.
No, you didn't.
No.
What did you?
I said that he put his fig leaf on his fig. Oh. I've got a lot of pressure on my brain right now.
Yes,
the hormone imbalance,
right.
You know, when you're in that condition.
Her hormonal imbalance has affected her thinking, hasn't it? Okay, that's five for you, and now we go to round two and ask Gene to make a selection.
Try B again.
B again. All right, here we go.
Okay.
The psychiatrist said, He said, you know that patient I just treated who says he's a kleptomaniac? He says, I never took my eyes off him, but somehow he took my blank.
Eyes? Oh, yeah.
Psychiatrist, please. You know the patient I just treated, he says he's a kleptomaniac. Never took my eyes off him, but somehow
he took my
blank.
Ta-da.
There's a reading help there.
Psychiatrist.
Yes. Yes, you got the idea.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Yes, you know about them.
Not personally, but...
Well, I do. I'm not ashamed of it.
I'm not ashamed of not knowing that.
He's done wonders.
Charles!
He is getting better, isn't he?
The nurse is helping me.
Yes. I put it in a slot, Charles, and stop fiddling around. Use two hands because you're a beginner. Now, Gene. Psychiatrist said, you know that patient I just treated who says he's a kleptomaniac? He says, I never took my eyes off him, but somehow he took my...
Couch.
Good answer. Excellent answer she gave.
She
said, you took my couch. She's a kleptomaniac, walked out with the couch. What do you say to that, Jack?
Well, I thought the couch was too heavy, so I said it was a wallet.
Wallet is good, too. Right, gotta match everybody else to stay in the game, Gene. Here we go, Brett.
Oh, golly, gee whizzingers. I said wallet.
Wallet, so Vicky wins the game. What do the rest of you have? Couch. Two couches for enough. Now, Gene, it was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
We wish you the very best of luck in your career in, here in Los Angeles. What's the department again now?
County of Los Angeles, DPSS.
DPSS?
Yeah, Department of Public Social Service.
It's a pleasure meeting you. We've got some gifts for you together with
our
thanks.
Thank you.
Gene McLaurin, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye.
Yes. Vicky says we've got to stop meeting like this. Here we go again, Vicky. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Fun blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. You match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one gives you $100. Whom do you call on?
I'll try Jack.
Jack, what do you say?
Jack, dear.
What's that?
Hello, Jack.
Don't wake me up. What is it?
Fun blank.
Fun city.
Fun city. All right. Well, you're writing a three-act play there, are you?
No, it's only a two-act play.
I see. Okay. So there's one, Fun City. Whom else do you want to call it?
Richard.
Richard.
The reason for this, fun and games.
Fun and games. I'll give you two.
Brett?
Well, I guess the only one left is Fun House.
Fun House. So it gives you Fun City, Fun House, and Fun and Games. Would you like to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
If I could, I would, so I'll say Fun House. If I could think one of my own.
Yeah.
Fun House.
Fun House you think is the best. All right, that's Brett's answer. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response, if you please. Fun House, right off the bat. There it is. Well, that always kind of catches us by surprise, Vicky, when it comes up right off the bat like that. Fun House. Now, what do you suppose is under the 250? Fun City. You're right about that, madam. And under the 500, we have Fun and Games. Fun and Games. They're all up there. Okay, now you're going to play for $1,000, Vicky. Last time you chose Richard. That means you cannot choose him this time. You may choose any of the others.
I'll try Brett.
Okay, Brett, get ready to write. Vicky faces me. Here we go for $1,000. Second blank. Second blank. Second blank. Now she's finished. Vicky, we ask you for your response. What answer do you want to give us which you think will match hers? Second?
Second hand.
Second hand. You got a lukewarm... Get a lukewarm hand on that from the audience. Let's see what Brett has for $1,000.
I said second chance.
Second chance. Okay, Vicky. I want to announce to you that with your additional 100 here, that gives you a grand total of $6,600. Now we've got a little message for you. Come right back. Listen, I want to remind you one more time. Next week, June 16th, a new exciting show begins here on CBS called Musical Chairs.
Who's the star of it?
The star will be Adam Wade.
Good.
And
when's
there'll be a lot of celebrity guest performances and music and fun. And that's going to follow our program beginning June 16th. And then Tattletales, which normally follows our program over most of this station,
will
move to 11 o'clock in the morning Eastern Time, 10 o'clock Central and Pacific Time. Any questions?
No, thanks.
No. You have a question. Well, then let's press on, shall we? And meet our new player. Let's welcome John Reed. Hello, John. How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
Good. John will now tell us the story of his life. Go.
I'm married to my high school sweetheart from Jefferson, Texas. We have three fine boys, and I'm a sales representative. My hobbies are golf and tennis.
Golf and tennis?
Yes.
What's your handicap in golf?
9.
9 is good. Oh, he's an ace. He's very good.
Is that good, 9?
9 is very good.
Oh, good.
That's good luck to you here, John. Shall we begin?
Thank you.
Here we go. Please make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Brand new game. Alice said to Larry, where did you get those awful marks on your face? And Larry said, well, I had a bit too much to drink last night, and I fell asleep with my head on a blank.
Where did you get those awful marks on your face?
Larry said, well, I had a bit too much to drink last night. I fell asleep with my head on a blank.
On blank. Got it.
And that's how he got those awful marks on his face. Oh, this is such an intellectual exercise, friends. You have no idea how difficult it is to be up here competing with these giant intellects.
I'm glad I'm home myself.
All right.
Charles hasn't even waked up yet, dear.
There he goes.
He's moving.
Leave him alone. Now, you'll break his concentration. You have to start all over
what
again.
What concentration?
Jack is ready, so we'll press on.
Oh, we did break his concentration. He's thrown away his card.
Starting all over. Too late, Charles. Come on, Charles.
I thought you all were fresh from your trip to New York.
We're running out of music, Charles.
Not this tune, you ain't. This goes on and on and on. And I've heard it for 2 damn years. And it still ain't catchy.
Welcome to Musical Chairs, starring Adam Wade.
That's
and Bert
Cut.
Well, I've got an announcer's job coming up.
John Reed, are you ready?
I am.
Alice said to Larry, where did you get those awful marks on your face? And Larry said, well, I had a bit too much to drink last night, and I fell asleep with my head on a...
Sun lamp.
Just a minute
so
now.
Cool.
Just wait till the second round. He's got some worse answers than that. What do you say, Jack?
Well, I said he fell asleep with his head on a bar.
On a bar. Okay, and it broke a glass or something like that.
Right.
What do you say, Brad?
Oh, honey, you don't get any marks. You just put your little head down like that, and you're just happy as a pig in a pan when you wake up.
You should know.
A thousand times. No.
He fell asleep on a chenille bedspread.
Oh, yeah. That makes funny little things
makes
in your face.
Oh, yeah. Makes you look like you've got a double case of the measles.
Yes. Yes, I've had that experience. So what do you say, Charles?
In keeping with the absolutely crummy answers, I present mine, an electric blanket.
All right, we got three losers up there. And now let's see what the lower tier offers. That's four rotten answers in a row, including his. What do you say?
Well, I like chenille bedspread.
Not to be outdone, a broken bottle.
A broken bottle. Oh,
that's the smartest answer so far.
No, that's good. So far, you're the best, my dear.
Oh, I'm the best?
You're the best.
The best of the worst? He'll
that's
turn
exactly
on you
right.
in a minute, Lynn.
What
Don't
do you say?
Trust him.
Get ready
I
for this.
I say, I love a parade. Anything else you want to know what I see? Now your handicap's 9 in golf, is it?
Yes.
What would you give it in this particular game?
Only about 20.
Yeah, you drunks, they fall down in the street, don't they?
Right.
Got all those marks on a drain.
On a sewer. Oh, yeah, of course.
Well, I didn't say sewer, that's ghost.
That's right, of course.
Of course.
Now we've got another intellect coming up over here.
Yes.
What have you got there? What are you showing and telling
I said he
here?
Fell asleep with his face on a waffle iron.
Waffle iron is a good one there. So, you getting the hang of it, Vicky? All right, this is Vicky's first round question there. How come your light is on, Jack? Is there a card in there?
Yes, certainly is.
Okay.
Don't worry about a thing.
Now, Gloria said, my husband is weird.
How weird is he?
Yes. When he takes a milk bath, he fills a tub with milk and then he puts blank in it. Fills a tub with milk, then he puts blank in it. That's how weird he is.
When he takes
good, you're the best.
Takes a bath?
When he takes a milk bath, he fills a tub with milk, then he puts blank in it. Weird. Aren't you glad you came, Jack?
Yeah.
Meet all these weirdos?
Yes.
Listen to all these weird questions? Okay, we got them. Press along now. Here we go. Vicky, ready over there. Gloria said my husband is weird. When he takes a milk bath, he fills a tub with milk, and then he puts blank in it.
Chocolate.
Chocolate. He says chocolate. What do you say, Jack?
Well, I thought he put an egg in it, make some eggnog.
All right, that's not bad. Brett?
Oh, well, I thought the poor little devil had an ulcer, and I said scotch.
Scotch. That'll help, Charles.
Strange, you don't have an ulcer.
Chocolate! Yeah, that was one. What have you got, Lynn?
Chocolate!
That's two chocolates.
I thought he was Juan Valdez and put coffee in.
Coffee in there. And what do you say?
This is another... This is Ovaltine.
Ovaltine. Is that chocolate?
No, oh, that's chocolate.
No. Is not chocolate, no matter how you look at it. It looks the same, but it is a totally different derivative.
My mother used to get me to drink it by saying it had chocolate in it.
Well, your mother was a liar. That's why. Now we got this message of interest to one and all gathered here on this day. Quiet! Thank you all. Next time we get together, these are the people you will have the pleasure of meeting.
Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Meredith, Richard Dawson and Joyce DeLaPont.
Terrific! Team Labor, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.